Hello guys, so today we will discuss group 1 paper 5 financial accounting under the topic study note 12 accounting standards. Okay, so accounting standards study note 12 page number is 527. Okay, it is 527. So I am using the August 2019 edition. So examination point of view, you have around 15% of the marks allotted for accounting standard and accounting system in computerized environment. There is two topics, one is accounting standard, another one is accounting system under computer environment. Okay, what is the exact name for that? So this is the breakup of your syllabus. So 40% is for section A, 25% is for section A, 40% is for section B, and 20% is for section C, and 15% is for section D. That is accounting in computerized environment and accounting standards. Okay, so most of the students used to ignore the section D, that is computerized accounting and accounting standard, but in examination point of view it is very important. Under the compulsory question, 1 mark you can expect around 2 to 3 marks from accounting standard itself. Just match the following and true or false you can expect. Institute is testing regularly, minimum 2 to 3 marks in 1 mark. And recently they are testing the problem from accounting standards. Around 5 to 6 marks is given for the accounting standard problem. And also short notes, also they are testing around 4 to 8 marks in accounting standard as well as from computerized accounting. So you can expect around from accounting standard itself around 10 marks in examination. Plus along with computerized accounting you can expect around 10 to 15 marks in examination. Okay, that is what the breakup is given here. See, breakup, it is 15%. So today we will discuss about accounting standards. So study note 12 accounting standard. Under that, before getting into the accounting standards, we have to understand what is accounting standard. So before account that, you just go through the topics. It is AS1 is disclosure of accounting policies, AS2 valuation of inventory, AS7 construction contract, AS9 revenue recognition, AS10 property, plant and equipment, PPE, and another one is Ind AS. Ind AS is not applicable for you. Intermediate level Ind AS is not applicable. There is a notification on this on Institute also, it is available from Institute. There is a notification. So Ind AS is not applicable for inter level examination. Okay, so then what is accounting standard? What is the purpose of accounting standard? What is accounting? Accounting is recording, classifying, summarizing and analyzing the events and transactions. Correct. Analyzing, recording, classifying, summarizing the financial transaction. For preparation of financial statement, accounting is done with application of lot of principles and policies. Correct. Then what is standard? What is standard? What is standard? General meaning. Some sort of procedures, some sort of benchmark procedures we can say. Some sort of rules and regulations you can say. Rules, regulations, policies, procedures, all these terms can be linked with the standard. Correct. So you know what is accounting. It is an recording the transaction, classifying the transaction, summarizing the transaction and analyzing the transaction also. That is accounting. Okay. We know for the accounting what is golden rule. What is golden rule for accounting? So golden rule for accounting is what? So debit what comes in, credit what goes out, personal account, real account, nominal account. Correct or not? Then why there is an accounting standard required? What is the purpose of accounting standard? Just go through the theory here and I will explain what it is. Accounting standard is a method or an approach established and issued by a recognized expert accountancy body. It is used in preparing financial statement, that is P&L account and balance sheet of various concerns operating different fields. The main purpose of formulating accounting standard is to standardize the diverse accounting policy with views eliminating to the extent possible the incomparability of information provided in financial statement within or across the organization, so that users of a foresight statement do not get confused while evaluating the results to take various decisions to subscribe in equity shares or subscribe in debentures or that concern. Okay, so what they are trying to say, so accounting is done by accountant with the basic knowledge of golden rules: debit what comes in, credit what goes out, debit all expenses and losses, credit all incomes and gains. Okay, debit the receiver, credit the giver. Based on that golden rule, we can pass any type of financial transaction entries. But the point is, there are areas where we have to take some decision on the financial transaction. For example, capital expenditure versus revenue expenditure. Assets purchased, what is the accounting treatment? We have to debit our P&L account or we have to capitalize? You got it or not? So where it is given, how to identify that? How do we know when to capitalize the asset or when to recognize that as an expenses? Okay, purchase of car or purchase of building, whether it is a capital expenditure or revenue expenditure, it's a capital expenditure. But how to account under the accounting? What is the standard available for that? AS 10. AS 10 deals with property, plant and equipment related to fixed assets. So there the guidance is given how to account, when to account, what manner we have to account. So there the standard involves, there the standard knowledge is required. And another area, valuation of inventory, closing stock. Closing stock can be valued at what price? Whether it is a market price or whether it should be purchased at the historical cost or market price? Should be at the cost or net realizable value, whichever is lower. Where it is given? It is given in accounting standard. It is not given under any other area. It is given under the accounting standard. Likewise, there are many areas where the accountants need some guidance, where the accountant needs some expert advice. Got it or not? And also for many other purpose also, if all the companies are following these accounting standards, there will be some uniformity in preparation of financial statement, because all are following the same rules and regulations. When all are following the same rules and regulations, and you can interpret the financial statement easily, and you can compare the financial statement between one company and another company easily, because all of them followed the same type of accounting standards, it is easily comparable now. Okay, so because of that, the errors are reduced, frauds and also reduced. They have a better disclosure. As an investor, I can have a better decision on the financial statement. Correct? So there are many reasons. That's what said here. Actually, if you go through the second para, the main purpose of formulating accounting standard is to standardize the diverse accounting policy within views eliminating to the extent possibility of incomparability of information provided in financial statement within or across the organization. So what are they saying? Each company are following their own principles and policies. Got it or not? Someone will follow valuation of inventory by, they will adapt cost method. One will adapt the net realizable value method. Likewise, fixed assets, they don't have a proper accounting. If they don't have a proper accounting standard, they will account as per their wish. So if everybody is following the same rules and principles, that is standards, then you can compare the X versus Y easily. X versus Y means there will be a company, for example, automobile company you take, large company. That X Limited is an automobile company and Y Limited is also an automobile company. I want to invest in X or Y. I want to take a choice whether I should invest in X or whether I should invest in Y. So if I want to take this decision, what basis I can take? When can I take? How can I take? For that, what is required? For that, financial statement is required. So if financial statement is required, when can I take decision on, when can I compare between X and Y easily? If the both the companies are following same principle, same accounting standard, so that there is some discipline in their preparation of financial statement, so that there is some uniformity in their financial statement. Both of them valued as per valuation of inventory as per AS2. Both of them valued their fixed assets as per AS10. Okay. So in such a case, I can compare easily. Okay. Like this, there are many benefits. In India, the accounting standards are issued by instead of Chartered Accountant of India. So, with this understanding, you will go to the advantages of accounting standards. You can expect a theory question from this area. That's why I am discussing. You can expect a theory question in this area. So, advantages of accounting standards. Before that, there is small error in this material. Just look at the second para, last line. Various decision. The accounting standard is helpful for various decision to subscribe in equality of equality shares. It is not equality share, it is equity shares. Or subscribe in debentures of that concern. So what they are trying to say, if they follow proper accounting standards, I can invest in their company. I can invest in their company by purchasing the equity shares. Okay. Why? Because they have a proper standard in their financial statement. So that I can reliable, it will bring reliability to their financial statement. Authenticity and reliability to their financial statement. Okay. So it is not equality share, it is equity shares. To subscribe in equity shares. Just we will go through the advantages of accounting standard. So what is the first point? It provides the accountancy profession with the useful working rules. Of course, with the help of accounting rules or accounting standard, I am able to prepare financial statement properly because I have a guidance. I know how to account the inventory. I know how to value the inventory. I know how to account the fixed assets. I know how to recognize my revenue. AS9, revenue recognition. How? Because accounting standard is there. They gave the detailed explanation and detailed procedure to prepare the financial statement, to account the inventory. Okay, like that. So what is the next item? Second point. It assists in improving quality of work performed by accountant. Of course, if I am following some standard, proper standard, my quality of financial statement will be improved definitely. I don't do mistakes, I don't do errors, and frauds also reduced. Okay. What is the third point? It strengthens the accountant resistance against the pressure from directors to use accounting policy which may be suspected in that situation in which they perform their work. So what they are trying to say? Sometimes what will happen, senior management of company, CEO, director level, they will try to do some fraud. They will try to do some fraud or they will try to manipulate the books of accounts by putting different figure or by passing different entry. They can inflate the profits. They can inflate the profit. Likewise, they can do some modification in financial statement. If the accountant is restrained from doing that by following accounting standard, then he can escape from that situation. Then he can escape from a situation because accountant can say, accounting as per accounting standard, we can't do like that. that is not allowed under the accounting standard, so that accountant can escape from the fraud, from doing fraud. Okay, what is the next one? It ensures the various users of financial statement to get complete crystal information on more consistent basis from period to period. Okay, so various users means what? Shareholder, who is using the financial statement? Investor will use the financial statement, and government will use the financial statement, and bankers will use the financial statement. So that will be helpful for the users. How it will be helpful? Because they followed the accounting standard, so I can rely on their financial statement. Consistency will be there. Consistency means what? Performing and following some procedures continuously. We are not changing, we are not modifying the policies regularly. We have to follow consistently some policies. Okay, what is the next one? It tells the user to compare the financial statement of two or more organizations engaged in same type of business operations. It tells the users compare the financial statement of two or more organizations engaged in same type of financial business operations. Of course, if all the companies are following same accounting standard, then I can compare their sales, then I can compare the profit between two companies, so that I can take wise decision. Okay, this is advantages. Then come to disadvantages. So disadvantages of accounting standard. What are these disadvantages of accounting standard? So users are likely to think that said statements prepared using accounting standards are infallible. What is that one? Disadvantages. So generally what will happen, if accounting standard is followed, then there will not be any error, or there will not be any mistakes, there will not be any frauds. That is the assumption, or that is the belief will come to the account, that is the belief will come to the users of the financial statement. That is what said here as infallible. Infallible means, that does not mean accounting standard is followed, everything is correct. We have to open our third eye and we have to go through the financial statement. Okay, we should not simply rely on the accounting standard itself. We have to monitor in depth whether is there any, still there is any fraud or error in the financial statement. That is what they said. Okay, then what is the next one? They have been derived from social pressure, which may reduce freedom. General point. Then the working rules may be rigid or bureaucratic to some users of financial statement. Of course, accounting standard is not an easy job, or it cannot be understood by the common man normally, accounting standards. Okay, because the working rules is little bit rigid. What are the things? The more standard there are, more costly the financial statement are to be produced. Of course, accounting standard implementation or accounting standard review requires professional support. Only professionals like us, chartered accountant, cost accountants, can understand the accounting standards, not others. That's what said here. The more standards that are, the more costly the financial statement are to produce. Okay, meaning you have to invest on the experts, you have to invest on the professionals for, you know, complying the accounting standards. Okay, so with this meaning for accounting standard and advantages and disadvantages of accounting standard is over. So the first accounting standard, AS1, that is disclosure of accounting policies. What is this disclosure of accounting policies? So this is general, it is this general topic actually. What they are trying to say here is, whenever you are preparing a financial statement, you would have followed many accounting policies. You would have followed many accounting policies for many reasons. So as a group one inter level, you may not be aware about different accounting standards. There are around more than 30 accounting standards available. that all those 30 accounting center deals with different area actually. As you may not be aware about all those accounting standards, simply we will discuss what is required for you. Okay. So this disclosure of accounting policy is whenever you are preparing the financial statement, whenever you are preparing the financial statement and presenting the financial statement, while preparing the financial statement, you would have used different type of accounting policies. For example, inventories. Inventory is valued how as per AS2. AS2 valuation of inventory, it is valued how it is valued at your level. Cost or net realizable value, whichever is lower. So that is one accounting standard I followed, AS2. That I have to disclose. I have to disclose that I am followed the valuation of inventory as per AS2. Likewise, there are different area where this accounting policy, disclosure of accounting policy required. This is nothing but I am informing to my users, I am informing to my shareholders, bankers, government, that is their stakeholders, they are my users of the financial statement. I am just disclosing to them that how I prepared this financial statement, with the help of what I prepared this financial statement, what are the accounting standards I followed, whether is there any deviation from the accounting standard, that also I have to disclose, whether I deviated, whether I changed my accounting policy or not. That also I have to disclose. We will discuss all those things. So here what they said actually. This standard deals with the disclosure of significant accounting policies followed in the preparation and the presentation of the financial statement, and is mandatory in nature. Whenever you are preparing and presenting the financial statement, whatever the significant accounting policy you followed should be disclosed. Should be disclosure means you are just sharing the information in the financial statement. Below to the financial statement, notes to accounts will be there. Now there you have to write all these points. How you arrived the value of closing stock, how you arrived the value of investment, how you arrived the value of fixed cost, whether is there any changes from the existing accounting policy, like that. Okay. So accounting policies refer to the specific accounting principle adopted by the enterprise. Proper disclosure would ensure meaningful comparison both intra enterprise and also enable the users to properly appreciate the financial statement. If you properly disclose the information, then users can appreciate your information, meaning they can take better decision. Okay. Areas involving different accounting policies by different enterprises. Normally everyone will follow golden rule. Personal account, real account, nominal account, only everybody is following. Then why we should disclose? That question may arise in your mind. Personal account, real account, nominal account is followed. Okay. But there are some items where we have to change the figures. For example, methods of depreciation. Methods of depreciation, depletion and amortization. In one company they will follow SLM and another company they will follow WDV. Correct. Because of that there will be difference in the fixed assets value. Because of that there will be difference in their depreciation amount. So unless they disclose the method of depreciation, we can't compare between X and Y company. Correct. So then they have to disclose. Then treatment of expenditure under construction. Treatment of expenditure during construction. So how to treat this expenditure? This might be belongs to maybe AS7 accounting for construction, or this might be belongs to AS10 also. Okay, or this might be belongs to AS26 also, intangible assets. AS10 is for property, plant and equipment, that we will discuss. Then you come your level, you see what is the next item, valuation of inventory. Cost or net realizable value, whichever is lower, I have to value. That I have to disclose. Like treatment of intangible asset, valuation of investment. What is the how to, why this is required? For example, you take presently this Reliance Communications shares. Reliance Communications went to liquidation, correct? It is went to bankruptcy, and share price of Reliance Communication is around 500 rupees. before 1 year or more than 1 year, it is around 400 to 500 rupees. Presently, the share price is only 2 rupees, it's less than 2 rupees. Year before or 2 years before, it is around 400 to 500 rupees share. Now it becomes only 2 rupees. Say for example, I invested in the Reliance Communication shares. When I purchased, the share price is 400 rupees. What is the cost of purchase? 400 rupees per share. I am still having that share with me. Presently, the share value is only 2 rupees. Whether I should present this in my balance sheet as an investment in 400 rupees or 200 rupees. Sorry, 400 rupees or 2 rupees. 400 rupees I should present for the present year or 2 rupees I have to present. What is the present market price? It is 2 rupees only. So what I should follow? Whether I should present as a 400 or whether I should present as a 2 rupees? Where are the guidelines? Where I can get those guidelines? I can refer valuation of investment. That is AS 13. That is not for you. That is not there in your syllabus. Okay. But for example, I am just saying this one. Okay. So like this, there are many area where this accounting policies, different accounting policies is followed by different company. Unless if you disclose, users may not understand. Okay. So this is the purpose of disclosure of accounting policies. So next topic is factors governing the selection and application of accounting policies. This is very, very important for a examination point of view. Fundamental accounting assumption. You can say fundamental accounting assumption. Sorry, this one actually. Fundamental accounting assumption. This is very, very important. Fundamental accounting assumption. So as per AS1 disclosure of accounting policy, under that, whenever the company is preparing the financial statement, they need to assume and they need to follow all these fundamental accounting assumption. With this assumption only, everybody is preparing the financial statement. Okay, what are all those assumptions? Certain basic assumption in the preparation of financial statement are accepted and their use are assumed. No separate disclosure is required except for non-compliance in respect of. So whenever I am preparing the financial statement, it is assumed that all these three principles is followed. All these three as principal assumption is followed. What is the first one? Going concern. What is this going concern? So whenever I prepare the financial statement, I will always assume this company is going to exist. This company is going to alive for the n number of years. Meaning, so whenever somebody, for example, X is going to start a business, he started the business. That X will not assume or presume that I am going to close this business within this year. After 2 years, I am going to close this business. Definitely. After 3 years, I am going to close this business. Nobody will think like that. Okay. Similarly, whenever we are preparing the financial statement, that I will assume this company is going to live, it is going to live in foreseeable future. But that is what said here. Going concern, continuing operation in the foreseeable future and no interim necessity of liquidation or winding up or reduction sale of operation. So whenever you are preparing the financial statement, you always assume this company is going to live. Okay. That is the assumption, positive assumption that when you have decided this company is going to be closed, then you have to prepare the financial statement in different manner. You should not follow all this accounting standard, because this accounting standard is applicable for only living company, only the company is going to live. Okay, not the company going to be liquidated. For that, this accounting standard is not applicable. We have to prepare liquidation accounts. that is different actually. Okay, so that is first assumption, going concern. What is the next one? Consistency. Consistency means simple accounting policies or consistency from one period to another. What is the thing? You can say consistency in the accounting policy. Say for example, small example, I follow SLM, I follow depreciation under the SLM method, straight line method. First year I followed the straight line method. And next year what I should follow? Straight line only I should follow. Third year what I should follow? Straight line only I should follow. Fourth year what I should follow? Straight line only I should normally every company will follow. There is a company. In that company, in first year they will follow SLM. Second year they will follow WDV. Third year they will follow SLM. Fourth year they will follow WDV. Fifth year they will follow SLM. Whether is there consistency in their method of depreciation? Whether they are doing the method of working out the depreciation consistently under the one category? No. They are changing the category. They are changing the method. One first year they are providing SLM. Second year they are providing WDV. So consistency is not there. That is what consistency. When you follow something, you have to follow continuously, consistently. If you want to change, there should be a reason for that. Otherwise, without reason, you should not change the accounting policy, simply. Okay? Only if there is a legal requirement or any better presentation because of that change of accounting policy, then only you have to change the accounting policy. Okay? Otherwise, no need to change the accounting policies every year. Then what is the next one? Accrual. What is this accrual? Accounting can be done under two methods. One is accrual method, another one is cash method. What is accrual method? It is a double entry concept. Whenever the transaction is incurred or occurred, or events and transaction is incurred or occurred or earned like that, okay, you should pass the entry, you should pass the journal entry whenever there is a transaction occurred. You should not wait for the cash payment. Only after I will receive cash, then only I will post entry. Till that, I don't post any entry. Sales made to X on credit, what is the entry you will make it? Under the accrual method. X account debit to sales account credit, correct? X account debit to sales account credit. That is the first entry you will pass. That is accrual method. Under the cash method, only if there is a receipt of cash from the X, then only you will pass entry. Till that, you will not pass the double entry. You will pass only single entry. So most of the private companies and public sector companies follows only double entry system. Okay, I guess some of the few government companies still follow the cash accounting, cash method. As per the material, what is accrual? Revenues and costs are accrued, that is they are earned or incurred, not actually received or paid, and recorded in the financial statement. Extends to matching revenue against relevant cost. What they are trying to say, whenever you are generating revenue or whenever incurring expenses are accrued, that is they are earned or incurred, you need not to spend out of your packet, or you need not to receive the amount in your packet. Just whenever it is occurred, whenever it is accrued, okay, that time itself you have to pass the entry in your books of account. That is double entry system. That is accrual method. Okay? That is accrual method. So, first one is going concern. Second one is consistency. Third one is accrual. This is very, very important. Fundamental accounting assumptions. What is the next one? In continuation to fundamental accounting assumptions, there are some additional important factors. While preparing the accounts, we have to follow these factors. So factors governing the selection and application of accounting policies are prudence. What is prudence? What is generally prudence? So what they are trying to say is, so whenever we are preparing the accounts, whenever we are preparing the accounts, there will be some situation, there will be some scenario where there are some uncertainty exist. There are some uncertainty exist. For example, provision for expenses, provision for expenses, or provision for doubtful debts. Provision for doubtful debts. What is the meaning of provision for doubtful debts? We made a sales actually. We have not received the amount. It is in our debtors. You know debtors, correct? Current assets. There are some scenario, there are some situation where we are unable to receive the money from our customers. But we don't know exactly how much we will not receive. How much we will not receive, we don't know exactly. But we may not be receiving some amount. Based on our past experience, assume from the total collection, 1% is our debtors. Assume from the total collection, for example, 1 crore is my total collection debtors. Out of that 1 crore, 1% is my doubtful debts. 1 crore into 1% is how much? 1 lakh rupees. So out of 1 crore, 1 lakh, I am having some doubt whether I will receive the money or not. That is my uncertainty. But in past 20 years, my doubtful debts, my bad debts is around 1% only. Based on my past, I am predicting the future. Based on the past experience, I am predicting the future. By predicting the future, I am making the provision of 1%. That is called prudence. When you are making provision, you should think about prudence. You should not make extraordinary or abnormal amount. For example, I want to make a provision of 25%. I have a doubt this year. I want to make 25% or I want to make 50% as a doubtful debts. Then prudence is not followed. Because when you are making provision, you are reducing your profit, correct? Because it is accounted as an expenses. So what they are trying to say is, you have to follow prudence when there is an uncertainty. You should not misuse the opportunity. You have to estimate the amount by adapting the prudence concept. Okay, that is called prudence. What is said here? Generally, maker of financial statement has to face uncertainty at the time of preparation of financial statement. These uncertainties may be regarded collectability of receivables, as I said, provision for doubtful debts. Collectability of receivable means related to debtors. What is the next one? Number of warranty claims. There are companies where they will sell the products first. There are some companies where they will sell the products. For example, you take FMCG, FMCG goods. For example, household goods. There will be lot of electronic items or electronic equipment we purchase. Sometimes what will happen? After that, it will not work properly. So that we will return back to the manufacturer, correct? That is called number of warranty claims. So as a manufacturer, I have to make some provision for this product failure or some defect failure. I have to make some provision, number of warranty claim. Out of total manufacturing unit, how many units will become damaged or how many units will become inefficient? Based on that calculation, I have to arrive the provision for number of warranty claims. This is called estimation. That estimation is based on prudence. Okay. So what is the thing that may occur? Prudence means making of estimates which is required under conditions of uncertainty. Okay. So when there is an uncertainty, you have to apply the prudence. You should not misuse the opportunity. You should not escalate. You should not manipulate the books of accounts by increasing or decreasing the provision. okay? You have to account it properly. What is the next item? Substance over form. What is this substance over form? This is again one more concept. Substance over form means, substance over form means legally only you should not, legal aspects only you have to, you should not check. You have to think, you have to check the practical aspect also. Substance over form means legally might be, that might be the, somebody will be the owner, but actually I am the owner. For example, you take a two-wheeler purchase. For example, you take two-wheeler purchase. When the two-wheeler is purchased under EMI concept, two-wheeler is purchased under EMI concept. So when we are purchasing the two-wheeler under EMI, we used to get the two-wheeler and we can ride and we have a key and we have a insurance, everything, and two-wheeler is with us, correct? But legally, who is the owner till completion of EMI? Till completion of EMI, who is the owner legally? Only the financier is owner legally, because he is only financed the vehicle, correct? When, until you complete the loan amount fully, till that he is the owner and you are just an user. But this is legal form. This is called legal form. But practically if you see, even though he is owner, but you already take the possession of the vehicle and you are also taken the responsibility for risk and rewards also with you, possession of vehicle also with you, you are maintaining, you are paying the insurance. So practically you are the owner, but legally he is the owner, because until the last EMI, the ownership, legal ownership is with him. But in an accounting language, when you purchased the asset, when you purchased the vehicle, when you purchased the motor vehicle, you are the owner and you can claim depreciation in your books of accounts. That is called substance over form. That is called substance over form. Substance over form means substance over legal form. Substance is matter actually. Matter means that particular transaction. Transaction over. We have to see the transaction, not legal aspect. We have to see the actual usage, not legal one. Okay, that is called substance over form. What is given here? Substance over form. It means that the transaction should be accounted for in accordance with the actual happening and economic reality of the transaction, not by its legal form. Economically, I am the benefiter. That person who is using the two-wheeler, he is only using, he is having all the rights and he is only economically using those things. Like in higher purchase, if the assets are purchased on higher purchase by the higher purchaser, the assets are shown in the books of higher purchasers in spite of the fact that the higher purchaser is not the legal owner of the assets purchased. Under the purchase, the purchaser becomes the owner only on payment of last installment. Therefore, the legal form of the transaction is ignored and the transaction is accounted as per substance. That is called substance over legal form. By substance, I am the owner. Even though I am paying EMI, legally he is the owner, but by an accounting language I am the owner, because I am the actual user. I have taken the risk and reward myself. If anything is happened to two wheeler, I am responsible. Any damage or anything. Okay. What is the next one? Materiality. Another aspect is materiality. And the third item is materiality. What is this materiality? So whenever we are preparing the financial statement, we should disclose all the items and facts which are sufficient enough to influence the decision of reader or users of financial statement. What is the meaning that? So we should not hide the material information. We should disclose all material information properly to our investor so that they can take better decision. What is that material information? Material information means, generally, for example, you take, there is a company, their turnover is 1000 crore. Their turnover, their sales is 1000 crore rupees. Okay. How much their turnover? 1000 crore rupees. and their expenses is 800 crore rupees. Expenses is how much? Total expenses is 800 crores. Turnover is 1000 crore, expenses is 800 crore, net profit is 200 crore. Okay, net profit is 200 crore. So in this expenses 800 crore, they spent around 8000 rupees for stationery purpose. How much? Out of 800 crore, they spent around 8000 rupees for stationery, buying stationery, pen, pencil, all those things, rubber, pencil. For the company, they purchased around 8000 rupees, pen, pencil, all those stationery items. Now you tell me whether we should disclose this item separately as a separate line item in the financial statement, or we can produce under other expenses. We have to disclose this 8000 rupees separately, or we have to disclose in our notes to account separately there is one line item. We purchased pen pencil for 8000 rupees during the year. For 800 crore expenses company, whether this 8000 rupees is having any significant value or significant, it will affect our financial statement significantly. If we don't disclose separately, that will affect our user decision making or not? Tell me. It will not affect our user decision making, because it's a very minor amount, eager amount. If you compare with total expenses and total turnover, 8000 rupees of purchasing stationery is nothing. So we can include this under other expenses category. We need not to separately show under notes to accounts we purchased so and so things, because materiality is not there. Materiality, that is the meaning of materiality. Okay, materiality you can judge by value, or you can judge by matter also. What is that matter? For example, same, not even 8000 rupees, only 5000 rupees penalty paid by the company, same company to violation of Environmental Act. Violation of what? Environmental Act. As per the Environmental Act, they have to follow the environmental, they have to maintain the pollution. They should not spoil this pollution, but they violated. So a minor amount of 5000 rupees they paid as a penalty. Whether this is material item or non-material item, and also consequences if they repeat the mistake 3 times, then the government will close the company immediately. That is the consequences if they don't follow the environment rules. Now tell me whether this 5000 rupees is material item or not a material item. But their company is 1000 crore company, their expenses is 800 crore, and the net profit is around 200 crore. But they only spent 5000 rupees as a penalty. Now tell me whether this amount is material amount or not a material amount. Even though amount is very, very minor, very, very small amount, but the matter is serious. If they violate again this rules and regulation 1 or 2 times, then the government may close this company due to violation of environmental law. In such a case, this is material. So this is material item, even though it is small amount, but the matter is very big. That is how we have to present this material items. Okay, we should not only focus the amount, we have to focus the matter also, we have to focus the concept also, we have to focus the issue also, both together. Then only we have to decide whether this is material item or not a material item. That is called disclosure of material items. We should not hide this item from our investor. If we are hiding this 5000 rupees penalty from investor, what will happen? Investor will invest money further, but next year what will happen? If I did the mistake again, same mistake, that is I violated the environment rules again and again, then company will be closed immediately and my investor money will get lost. So that is why we have to disclose all the items that requires that influence the decision of the users. Okay, so this is materiality. What they said, as to disclosure of all material items individually or in aggregate in the context of fair presentation of financial statement as a whole, if it is omission or misstatement could influence the economic or financial decision of the user relying upon the financial statement. So you have to separately, you have to disclose, or you have to disclose along with the other items. Purchases, for example, you take purchases. Purchases of raw material X, Y, Z. I am purchasing different raw material X, Y, Z, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, S, like the different raw material I am purchasing. I will not disclose purchases of X is this much, purchases of Y is this much, purchases of Z is this much, purchases of A is this much, purchases of B is this much. Separately I will not disclose. Together all purchases together how much? Only one line item I will disclose. That is called all material individually or in aggregate. Aggregate means in the concept of our presentation, means that is what, together all purchases together I will disclose separately. Okay, so then change in accounting policy. So what I should disclose exactly? Disclosure of accounting policy means you understood that we are following different accounting policies. We need to disclose everything to our users of financial statement. So then whether I should disclose all the things which I am following regularly, I am following as per AS2 only, I am following AS7 properly, I am following AS9 properly, I am following AS10 properly, then what I should disclose? If I am following also, I should disclose. The what they are trying to say is if you don't follow or if you are changing the accounting policy, or you are following your own accounting policy, or you are modified the accounting policy, then you have to disclose. If you are following everything correctly, then you need not to disclose all the accounting policies in your financial statement. Disclosure means what? Disclosing in your financial statement, P&L balance sheet is there, no? Below P&L balance sheet, you have to disclose under the notes to accounts. Need not to, all the accounting standard need not to be disclosed. Only if there is any change in the accounting policy, you have to disclose definitely. And other significant accounting policies, anything you have to disclose. Okay, disclosure means just presenting to the shareholders, just presenting to the bankers, just presenting in your financial statement. That's what said here. Any change in the accounting policy which has a material effect in the current period or which is reasonably expected to have a material effect in the later period should be disclosed. So I am changing from SLM to WDV or WDV to SLM, because of that my depreciation is different, my depreciation amount is changed, my fixed asset amount is changed, then I have to disclose all those amount. Okay, in the case of change in accounting policy having material effect in the current period, the amount by which any item the financial statement is affected by such a change should also be disclosed to the extent as ascertainable. Because of that change, what is the financial impact? What is the depreciation before? What is the present depreciation? What is the fixed assets value before? What is the present fixed asset value? All those things I have to disclose. That is called disclosure. If there is a change in your accounting policy, because of that there is a financial effect, because of there is a material change in your financial statement, then you have to disclose all those items. Okay? The following are not considered as a changes in accounting policies. Accounting policies adapted for events or transactions that differ so and so things. Accounting policies pertain to events or transactions which do not occur previously. So, come to the problem now. So, from this problem, what they are trying to say? Jeevandeep Limited had made a right issue. Right issue means issuing shares to the existing shareholder. Right issue means issuing shares to the existing shareholder. In the offer document to its member, prospectus issuing to its members had projected a surplus of rupees 40 crores. That company is saying they are issuing shares to existing shareholder. In that they are mentioning our profit is 40 crores during the accounting year ended on 31st March 2012. Okay. The draft results for the year prepared on following policy, accounting policy and presented for perusal of Board of Directors shows a deficit of 10 crore. The board in consultation with management decided on the following things. So company is preparing one statement. In that statement, the surplus is 40 crores. Okay. But draft results prepared and board of directors, they submitted to the board of directors. So in that it is mentioned deficit is 10 crore rupees. There is two figures. One is 40 crore surplus profit. Another one is 10 crores deficit. Okay. The board in consultation with managers decided on the following things. Okay. So the company is having two figures. One is they are saying that profit is 40 crore and another figure they are having 10 crore for the same financial year. Okay. Now we have to understand why there is a change. Why there is a 40 crore, why there is a 10 crore, why it is changed. Okay. How it is changed? Now we will go through. Value year-end inventory of work cost 50 crore rupees instead of hitherto method of valuation of inventory of prime cost 30 crore rupees. So what they are trying to say? So previously they used to value their closing stock for 50 crore rupees. Now they are valuing at 30 crore. Why? Because previously they followed work cost. Now they are following prime cost. Prime cost is what? Direct material, labor, direct overheads will give the prime cost. Work cost, we have to add some additional cost also, factory overheads and other things. Then you will get the work cost, correct? And the next one is provide depreciation. So usually they will use to provide depreciation on SLM basis, straight line method. And they charge depreciation of 27 crore. But we will go through the question. Provide depreciation for the year on SLM straight line basis or account of substantial addition in gross block during the year instead of reducing balance method, which had been hitherto adapted. As a consequence, the charge of depreciation at 27 crore is lower than the amount of 45 crores, which should have been provided had the old method has been followed by 18 crores. So what they are trying to say? Current year, what they did is they changed the depreciation method from SLM, from WDV to SLM. Present year they are following SLM method. Actually previously they followed WDV method. Okay. So because of SLM method, the present year they are charging only 27 crores depreciation. Previous year they charged 45 crores depreciation. So because of that, there is a reduction in expenses of 18 crores. Okay. We will work out the answer. Just I am going through the question. Not to provide for after sale expenses during the warranty period. Till the last year, provision at 2% on sales used to be made under concept of matching of cost against revenue, and the actual expenses used to be charged against the provision. The board now decided to account for expenses as and when actually incurred. Sales during their total year total to 600 crores. What they are trying to say here is, usually they will make provision for warranty. Usually they will make provision for after sale expenses 2% on sales. 2% on sales. But this year they ignored. This year they said when the actual damage is coming, that time you will account. Then they are not following the prudence concept actually. As per prudence, you have to estimate your losses and expenses. You have to make provision. But they are not following. Okay. So what they did is they followed 2% they provided. 2% on total sales they provided as a provision for after sale expenses. But this year they did not provide it. And another thing. Provide for permanent fall in the value of investment which had taken place over the past year, provisioning being 10 crore. So this year what they did is they are making provision for reduction in the value of investment. provision for reduction in the value of investment. I said no, Reliance Communication share. When I purchased it is 400 rupees, but the presently the value is only 2 rupees. When I purchased the Reliance share, it is that is 400 rupees, but the present value is how much? Only 2 rupees. So what is the reduction of value here? 398 rupees. 400 minus 2 equal to 398 rupees. I have to make a provision. Like this, they made here 10 crore provision during the year. So what we have to do? As a chief accountant of the company, we are asked by the managing director to draft the notes on accounts for inclusion in the annual report 2011-12. So why we are doing? Because there is change in the accounting policy. Change in the accounting policy. Because of that change in accounting policy, we are having lot of changes in our financial statement. So all these financial changes, financial statement changes should be disclosed properly under the notes to accounts. Okay. Now I will work out the notes to accounts. So under the notes on accounts, first point related to valuation of inventory. Correct? So why there is a change? They changed the inventory method actually. Previously what they did, valuation of inventory under what cost? Previously they did under work cost. So their inventory is 50 crore up to previous year. This year what happened? This is current year. This is previous year. Okay. Current year what happened? They are valuing under prime cost. That is 30 crore. Okay. One small change. This is current year and this is previous year. Okay. So current year they are valuing inventory under work cost. You know what is work cost, you know what is prime cost. So work cost, their value is 50 crore, closing stock value is 50 crore, previous year it is 30 crore only. So present year how much is increased? 20 crore is increased. Correct? If my closing stock is increased, value of closing stock is increased, whether my profit will increase or decrease? It will increase. My profit 20 crore will increase. That is the impact. I have to write due to adoption of this inventory policy by valuing at work cost, where inventory value is increased by 20 crores, that is having effect on my profit also. So hence the profit is also increased for 20 crores. You please refer the material answer. Proper explanation, you please refer the material answer. If my closing stock is increased, my gross profit also will increase. Remember your trading account. What will happen? All the expenses, purchases, all the things here, what will happen? By sales, by closing stock, you will write, correct? By closing stock, you will write. Difference is your gross profit, correct? That profit will be increased. If I have more closing stock, my profit will be increased this side. So like that, because of increase in the value of closing stock, I got an extra inventory of 20 crore. Because of this extra additional inventory value, my profit of 20 crores also will be increased. Okay, that is the impact. We have to write in a proper English. That is available in your material. Okay. What is the second one? So second one is related to change in depreciation method. Okay, that is the second one. So current year, what method they are following? Depreciation method. current year what they are following actually? Current year they are following SLM. Okay. What is the depreciation? What is the depreciation actually? What is the depreciation? 27 crores. Assume accumulated depreciation is 27 crore. Accumulated depreciation is 27 crore. Up to previous year. This is previous year. Up to previous year, they followed WDV. That is reducing balance method. WDV is reducing balance method. Under that method, they followed WDV method and their accumulated depreciation is 45 crore. Okay? So, till previous year, they charged 45 crores depreciation, but due to change in the method of depreciation, depreciation amount is reduced to 27 crore. Depreciation is an expenses or what? Depreciation is an expenses. Till previous year, my expenses is 45 crore. Suddenly, my expenses become 27 crore. There is an reduction in my expenses. Reduction in my expenses is how much? 18 crore. Correct? 18 crore reduction in expenses. Correct? If my expenses is reduced, then my profit will increase or decrease? My profit will increase. Correct? Because my expenses is reduced. So 18 crore, previous year 45 crore. Now I am revising this year to 27 crore. Because of that, I am saving 18 crores. That savings of 18 crores will increase my profit 18 crore. Okay? This you have to write in a proper manner, proper English. Please refer the material answer. Okay, for that. What is the third one? Third one is provision. Current year provision zero. Current year provision zero. Because this year decided by the company, we will not make any provision. Provision for warranty, the provision for after sale service, that is an expenses. They decided we will not make any provision. But till previous year what happened? They are making 2% provision. 2% on sales. 2% on sales. Previous year sales how much actually? Previous year sales 600 crore. Okay. So 600 crore into 2%. 600 crore into 2% how much? 12 crore. Okay. 600 crore into 2% how much? 12 crore. So previous year I made an expenses of 12 crore. This year 0. Previous year I made an expenses of 12 crore. This year 0. Because of that my expenses is reduced. My expenses is reduced for 12 crore. Correct? Because I am not provided anything this year. So I saved 12 crore this year. Because of that my profit may increase. My profit may increase for 12 crore. Because I have not made any provision. If I make this provision 12 crore, then my profit will be reduced to 12 crore. Because I don't made any provision during the year, my profit may increase for 12 crore. So this is also 12 crore increased. Correct? Then what is the last one? What is the fourth one? I am writing here itself. What is the fourth one? Till previous year, no provision. Provision is zero for investment. As I said, better I will write in next page so that you will understand properly. So as I said, value of investment. Okay. So what happened current year? What I am doing is I am making provision of how much? 10 crore rupees. in my investment. Provision means what? I am reducing my asset value. I am reducing my asset value and I am debiting my P&L account. Making provision for reduction in value of investment. Okay? Okay? Because of this, my present year profit 10 crore rupees will be reduced. 10 crore rupees will be reduced. Till previous year, I am just coming here. Till previous year, no provision. Till previous year, no provision. Zero provision as per the question. But current year only, I am suddenly making 10 crore rupees provision. Provision means, assume my investment value 100 crore rupees. Investment is an asset. On that, I am reducing this 10 crore. My asset becomes 90 crore now. So, this asset side, it becomes 90 crore. Profit, liability side profit also, I will reduce by 10 crore. So, this year what happens? This year what happens? Because of this 10 crore provision, my profit is reduced for 10 crore rupees. Okay? This is the concept. Now you can tally the answer. As per the projection submitted to shareholder, it is 40 crore surplus, correct? As per the projection submitted to shareholder, it is 40 crore surplus, correct? So how this 40 crore is arrived? Ultimately, so first case, change in inventory, because of that 20 crore profit increased. Second case, depreciation method is changed, because of that 18 crore increased. Third case, provision not made during the year, because of that 12 crore profit increased. Fourth case, provision made during the year, because of that 10 crore decrease, profit is decreased. So 20 plus 18 plus 12 equal to how much? 50 rupees, 50 crore. 50 crore minus 10 crore equal to 40 crore. That is how it is presented to the management. This we have to present in our notes to accounts. Why? Because change in accounting policy, change in accounting estimates. Okay? So, you can expect theory question from this topic as well as 1 mark. And sometimes problems like this also you can expect. And with this, AS1 is over. We will discuss AS2, AS7, AS9, AS10 in coming days. Okay? Thank you.